Ted Castellion, you're up next for the meet and greet.
Hi, Mr. Joel, Mr. Billy Joel. I'm Ted, but in the past, you called me Eddie. I can see the look on your face, you don't remember me, but I've got 5 minutes as part of this meet and greet. I'm gonna remind you. Now let me first tell you about where I am in my life right now. I am the Associate Regional Director of Tre Tremendous, which is the third largest supplier of lunch trays to schools in the Northeast. And you know how you get to a place like that, Billy? You know how you get to success? Motivation. Motivation will push you further, make you work harder. And the best way to get that motivation is to be written off, told that you're worthless, and have 15,000 people sing it back to you. Now, I see you don't get that, Billy, but now, I want you to picture this. It's 1977. We're at the Nassau Veterans Memorial Coliseum. Now, your show that night was very good. I was enjoying it very much. I love that song, Piano Man. But then you launched into Scenes from an Italian Restaurant, an interminably long song in which you compared yourself having a glass of wine in an Italian joint to someone else's life. And then I started to realize this person's life, whose life sounded, I gotta say, really terrible, was my life. And that, I gotta say, that really bothered me, Billy, especially since you and I had never met. I was trying to figure out how you learned about me, like, Buddy Chianese, maybe? Did he stooge me off? Because that guy was always a blabbermouth. But I will say, Billy, as I listen to that song, you've got a couple of things right. First, Brendan and Andy were the populist daddies and the king and the queen and the prom. Dead on, we were indeed the populist daddies and the king and the queen and the prom. That is correct. That is a true fact about my life. They started to fight when the money got tight. Now that is, in fact, wrong. Billy, we fought, Brenda and I, because Brenda came out to me as a lesbian. And it was the 1970s, and I will admit, I did not really understand at the time. But we have gotten over that, and since then, become very, very close friends. But then, the coup de grace was when you capped off the song by saying, Brenda and Eddie had it already by the summer of 75, and the height of the load at the end of the show for the rest of their lives. And I didn't like being told that it was the end of the show for me, Billy. And I knew it wasn't. Hey, Billy, stop telling me that I'm a fictional character. I am not in your head. I am here and I am real. And I've overcome that, Billy. I've thrived. I will work my way past a lot of people to become associate regional director. And I got a very nice bonus, which allowed me to pay the $924 for this 5 minute meet and greet. And so tonight, when I was sitting in the front row and you sang that song, all 7 minutes and 37 seconds of it, and yes, I counted, I knew that I had beaten you. I had won. You would hear more about me, and it wasn't the end of me. You feel stupid now, Billy? Hey, Billy, you don't have to get these security cards here. I'm not here to be angry with you. I'm just here to set the record straight. And I can see that my time is up, so I just have one more thing to say to you, Billy. Virginia, hey, come out, Virginia, don't make the man wait. Now that's a good song. This is my wife, Virginia. She's a big fan of yours. Would you sign signing a copy of Turnstiles?